Hello everyone, welcome to Laratips. In today's video, we'll be looking at three new things that are added to Laravel version 9.10.0. The first thing that has been added is this str or string method on the request object. Let me show you that. Currently, I am here in the Laratips.test and this is this Laratips.test home controller. Whenever I visit this, I am seeing this form. And whenever I submit this form, I'll be taken to this save user controller. Now let me just do here dd request name over here like this, and I'll say here hello world and save. Then we can see this name as a normal string. But the thing that has been added is that we can add here str or string like this. Let me just write str, and if I just add that name over here, then it will give us the stringable object instead of this simple string. Let me reload here. Then we can see this stringable object. And because of this, we can use all the methods that is available in this stringable object. Let's say I want to just here title like this, and let's say to string like this. It will just convert this stringable class into this normal string, okay? And this title will convert first letter of each and every word to the uppercase. And if I just reload here, then we can see here hello world with the first letter of each word being capitalized. This method can be very, very handy. The second thing that has been added is this findOr method on the Eloquent model. Let me go to this home controller. Let me show you that as well. User first, let's say find like this, and there is no user with the ID of 123. Let me add it inside a DD. Now if I come here and refresh the page, then I'll see here null. But let's say we want to show different thing. If there was no user found, then we can simply see here find or like this, and we can pass closer as a second parameter, and we can just say new user like this. Before there was first or method, and now find or method is also added. Now if there is no user, then we'll see this new user. I'll just reload over here, then we can see this new user model. And inside this attribute, so we don't have anything. But let's say we are passing here one, the user with the ID of one is present. So if I refresh here, then we can see this user with the ID of one. But again, let's say we only want the name of this user, then we can also pass here second parameter as the column's name, and we'll say name like this. And if I refresh here, then I will only see the name of that user. And finally, the third thing that has been added is this does not expect output to contain assertion method, by which we can easily test whether a string exists or not to the output of a command. Let me show you that. I have a test command over here. This is the test command, and I am just writing here this line, I am Laratips, and I am here in the test command test, which is inside this test feature, test command test, okay? And here this artisan test, I am running this test, and here I have written that method doesn't expect output to contain Laratips, but we have Laratips in the command, which means that this test should fail. So I'll just run this test, then you can see here the test has failed. But let's say I'll just add here a small letter L over here, and again I'll run the test, then it will get passed because it is case sensitive.